Yo, 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 my musicians out there, this is the Obnoxious Elbow, and welcome to something completely different here. This is what I'm going to be doing for my holiday special. It's something way totally different from Pokemon, so bear with me, guys, as I explain to you what I'm going to be doing. Okay. So what I'm basically going to be doing here in this game is I am going to be doing a Zelda quest from Zelda Classic. Now, for those of you who are not familiar with Zelda Classic, allow me to briefly explain before we get right on to this. Now, Zelda Classic is a program which allows you to play fan-made Zelda quests, as well as the original NES version, which I think is rather convenient, to say so in the least. But yeah, you can actually make your own fan-made Zelda quests by using a program that comes with Zelda Classic known as ZQuest or Zelda Quest. And with that, you can basically just be really creative and just use your own imagination and come up with your own variations on the... And either you can do it on the NES version, but you can also do it on Link to the Past or some other games like that. And you can use the items from the 3D era, including the Mirror Shield and the Lens of Truth and all that. Now, I found out about Zelda Classic through Picked Up on a Bus, and if you don't know who Picked Up on a Bus is, and I highly suggest you check out his material, because he actually mainly inspired me to do my own OPs. He's one of those few people that really influenced me to do this, but... Yeah, basically, this is what Zelda Classic is. It's just basically, it's a made-for-computer console, which allows you to play variations on the original Zelda. So there we go. Now, without further ado, let us take it from the top here, and let's do this for roughly 30 minutes or so, because that's usually how long my specials take. So let's actually start this off. And yes, guys, this is actually my own file. I already started this file for about a few seconds just to make sure that it actually worked. And fortunately it does, so let's actually... Okay. Here's the game I'm going to be doing here. It's Link's Quest for Christmas. Yeah, very appropriate, huh? Very appropriate indeed. Oh, okay. Now can we actually get started here? And yes, Carol of the Bells is playing. One of the very few Christmas carols I'll actually tolerate. Christmas is approaching in Hyrule. The time of lights and gifts. The time of inner peace and get together! Okay, that's kind of grammatically incorrect. However, Santa Claus has lost all his Christmas without capital C gifts. They are now spread all over Hyrule. Christmas now with a capital C is in danger. Merry, merry, Garmin, Link and his friends are planning to help Santa Claus without a capital S or capital C with his duties. Get ready for Link's quest for Christmas. Okay, well... Grammatical errors aside, let's see if we can actually compare the music. And yeah, the other good thing about using Zelda Quest is you can actually import your own MIDIs from certain websites. And hello, there's actually a Christmas tree in a cave. And oh, look what's without an apostrophe S under the Christmas without a capital C and tree. Okay, so I guess we wish you a Merry Christmas here, and I got a sword. Or actually, rather, it's more like a candy cane. No, he can't eat it. Nope, I guess not. It's probably not a candy cane. How funny. But anyway, let's actually head north. Oh, okay, so... shit. Okay, I think I'm gonna die here if I don't fare well against these moblins. Okay, I need to get a... I do have a shield, but... See, here's the thing. I kind of suck at the original Zelda. As I can't really seem to use my shield correctly sometimes, because using the shield is very hard in the original games. Damn! Because you have to precisely aim your shield right when the bullet's about to go towards you. You got a Christmas gift. Collect as many of them as possible. Okay. I can definitely tell that this is going to be really confusing, because this is, after all, being done blind, and let's see what's in this cave. Come here and buy some crap, will ya? I have lots of nice items. Well, apparently you have blue Kool-Aid for 40, and you have a red crystal drugs for 295 rupees, and you actually have a Valentine's Day heart for 10. Okay, well, unfortunately, I won't be able to buy. Actually, does that basically heal up your stuff? You know, I mean, does that heal up your health, or is that actually an extra heart container? Signs lead to just a normal heart, but I'll just check to make sure that. Okay, yeah, it actually heals up your health, so that was actually a bit of a waste. But anyway, let's actually go this way, which. Okay, I guess this is not an obstacle, so. Let's see. Or actually, no, never mind, that's actually impassable right now. So let's head east, shall we? So there's one P hat. I could try to aim for this P hat, but yeah, I think it's a lot better to have the arrows. I think to have the bow. Okay. And what a way to get hit by a moblin, Link. You're very stupid. And especially with that fire tunic. Okay, so there we have that. And let's cut the grass, why don't we? Because it's always fun to cut the grass. Did I? Oh, I actually got a heart for that. Hooray! I didn't actually get any allowance for that, but I got a heart nonetheless. And this. I don't recognize the music, but yeah, this is actually another. I wonder if this is actually a mini dungeon. Or something like that. Chances are I probably need, let's see. I need 14 keys in order for me to get that gift, which is kind of a downer, because I don't think I'll be able to get that gift. Okay, so let's get the Garayas too. Okay. Now let's actually get that very drugged out Octorok right here. If I can. If I don't die against it, that is. But yeah, we're basically growing up. This guy is really generous on rupees. Okay. Again, oh, yay, I got a key. Use them to unlock locked blocks. Okay, well, let's see if that actually works on this. Let's just see. It does. Okay, so we apparently need 13 more for that. Well, this is definitely going to be fun, guys. Just searching every nook and cranny through the land of Icy Hyrule. You know, the land of Winterfell, in order to actually find what we're looking. Oh, hello, Christmas tree. And yeah, for right now, since this basically, I think he only gave this as Hyrule, but I'm just gonna call it Winterfell because it looks like Winterfell anyway. Even though I definitely know that Winterfell did not have Octoroks and whatnot, so I'll just assume that Lord Stark had not even dealt with something like this. You know, he had never dealt with moblins or Octoroks or Garayas or Keese in his life. Thank goodness, because if Keese actually invaded my land, then I would probably go bananas. Just you know, a little heads up there. Again, I really suck at the shield. I'm sorry. So let's see what's over here. And here's another guy. There is a mysterious temple with dangerous monsters out there, so I'll pick up your ass. I heard that there is hidden a mystical item deep in the temple where I steal your balls if I had just a sword. Okay, anyway. Very, very stupid. Okay, let's actually go south, and we have, I think it's a dungeon or something, or something similar to that. Let's just see. Is it actually a dungeon? Well, I guess it can be close to that. We have Vires and Keese already, so. Oh, God. I'll be ready when you are, Keese. Okay, now let's actually see if we can get the Vire Keese over here. The Vire, not Fire Keese. Yeah, they're Red Keese, but they're not exactly called Fire Keese in this game. They're Vire Keese. And, okay, we have some Stoffos over here. Who throw candy canes, apparently. So apparently candy canes are actually really deadly for you. So yeah, hello, blue ring already. Do you want a wand? Oh, sure, I guess that was not the blue ring, even though it quite incidentally looked like it. So let's just actually head north, because apparently left is an invisible wall for very odd reasons. Okay, so there is that, and let's get the gel over here. It's Winter Wonderland. You know, to be honest, guys, I think it's kind of odd to actually play 16-bit music for an 8-bit dungeon, you know, for an 8-bit game. I mean, I'm just saying, guys, I mean, I just really don't think it's that suitable. I mean, it's my own opinion. That apparently did something. This is a puzzle. It's the ice caves of Johto all over again. Hello. Okay, so there we go. That'll do it. They'll put this block right over here. Maybe. There we go. Yeah, these blocks are kind of sensitive in a way, I guess. So let's do that and do that. And we're almost on our way. Maybe. Yeah, I think I may need to do that, because I bet you anything that block belonged to that slot over there. Even though, if this is going to take all day, then this is comedy gold here, or better yet, it's comedy silver, because I'm not really that funny anyway. Let's see. I only try to be. I only pretend to be funny, just so I can actually please you viewers, even though, I can be funny if I want to, but on certain occasions, I'm not. Actually, on a lot of occasions, I get really frustrated at some stuff. I get frustrated with technology a lot. Especially with dungeons like these. You know what? I'm kind of at a dilemma right now. Let me see if I can figure this out off screen. Okay, so after spending countless minutes trying to solve that puzzle, I just kind of decided to give up. Because it's only going to be like 30 or so minutes of recording here, so I'd rather just spend some of this time just exploring the rest of this dungeon and probably not face the boss. Hopefully this does not lead me straight to the first boss. I'm hoping not, but if it does, then oh well, I guess. But I mean, this is just basically going to be a 30-minute demo anyway, so yeah, I just want to get that out of the way. And I actually turned off the music here because of fear of copyright infringement, which, I mean, I know it's a lot better to hear the music, but I'd rather if I just mute the audio here than receive a lot of flack, because I think it's a lot better if I was able to maintain my channel without getting any copyright strikes. And this obviously did something. This also obviously did something. And this obviously all... Yeah, it opened this door. Okay, so let's see what's inside this door. Does this hopefully lead to the map? I guess not. Yeah. And apparently the keys are now flying sideways. Yeah, I don't think they really did that in the original game. They just basically were always front to back. They weren't exactly left to right. Is this a block moving puzzle? Do I have to move a block? No, I guess I was going the wrong way. So that was all for nothing, and no Vire, I'm not going to deal with you again. And no Joe, I'm not going to deal with you again either. I'm going to see what's to the right of here. If I can get inside, there we go. Oh, this was where I wanted to enter. So let's pull the lever and voila, I guess we can now go to the south end of that room. And apparently the designer forgot to limit the sound, you know, the Discovery fanfare music. After you did a puzzle or something, it does that da-da-da-da-da sound. So there we go, I guess. What's over here to the right? Oh, we have very fast Stalfos. Oh, what the heck? Those were deadly. Those were very deadly. Okay, well, That sucks. I probably won't go there again. Okay, let's go this way instead. You know, for a first boss, that sure was kind of a dick. I mean, having to deal with candy canes. Oh, ah! Okay. Estavo is Roy or Deadly? I mean, okay, so we can use another key. And we can destroy this jail before we obtain this gift, which is probably something which I'm probably not supposed to find out until the end of the game, which will not likely be happening. Okay. I wish I could just... How exactly... Oh my god, really? And no, guys, that's... It's my shield's fault for not really doing what it should be told to do. God, but I mean, their candy canes are deadly. It takes like 3 hits and you're done, basically. It just comes to show how much I suck at this game. But it's for the sake of trying. Ah, ha, ha. No, 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 no. I'm not being spearheaded this time. Okay, so let's. Okay, I should probably go the other way. Because of personal reasons, because I am religiously going that way instead. Please give me some hearts. No hearts, I guess. Oh, well, I guess. Never mind. You won't give me hearts because you're fucking heartless. You are fucking Scrooge. Thank you very much. I guess you aren't Scrooge, Joe. God bless us, everyone. Or actually, rather, to quote the gingerbread man from Shrek, God bless us, everyone! I didn't know I had that. Oh yeah, I had the wand, excuse me. I forgot I had that wand. Well, let's actually use the wand instead. Let's use the cancer stick. No, I'm just kidding. Okay, so anyway, yeah, I should... Oh my god, those are instant kills. Okay, well, that was kind of a Debbie Downer on this Christmas. That's a bad Debbie Downer there. Okay. Oh. Well, at least they don't consume rupees. Not like the bow and arrow. Okay, let's try to get away from the Stoffos as we can here. Oh, dear me. Oh, holy shitaroni. Why did I have to do this now? Why did I have to play a game with commercial music in it? Oh my god. Well, to be fair, some of that's in the public domain, but I mean, you know, a lot of people do their own renditions of it, and it's considered copyright. But I mean, considering that Carol the Bells was made after 1923, oh my god. How do I get through these, like, unharmed? Yeah, those are deadly. There's no way to get through that. I think I'm just gonna leave this dungeon and just... Fuck you. Just give a big old fuck you to this. So, yeah, and run into an Octorok. Hooray, and yeah. But now that we have 2 keys, we can actually... we can actually stupidly run into moblins, huh? Okay, so, yeah, with all that being said and done, let's actually head right back to that one cave, which was, I do believe, was up to, or I guess not. Oh, here we are. Here's where I was trying to get at. But now that I have the wand, I can actually kind of break the battles a little bit. And I can actually explore a little bit more for 5 minutes, just to see if I can progress any further. Which I don't... Well, maybe, we'll just see. But chances are I'm probably not going to be progressing a lot more through this game. It just comes to show how much I suck at the first dungeon here. And that, I do believe, was the first dungeon, guys. I mean, how am I supposed to get through those Stoffos, like, alive? Okay. So apparently we had a... We picked up another Christmas present, and These Octoroks are really annoying. They're annoying little pests that they are. So yeah, let's try to avoid them. And let's try to avoid you as well. And let's see what's in this cave. Oh yeah, I already talked to you. You're the we wish you a Merry Christmas guy. So I get to avoid you forever more. And get out of Goria. Or Goria. Whatever. I think I kind of lost my energy right now. Okay, so let's see. Where else should I go? Oh, I haven't been here yet. I have not been here yet. Let's see what's over here. We have another bridge, apparently. Okay, and yeah, let's actually be kind of daredevils and run into more enemies. And pick up another key! Oh yeah, keys! The keys to paradise. The keys to paradise, which are random keys scattered throughout the land. The keys to the kingdom of Jerusalem and of Ulaanbaatar. Okay. If you guys don't know what Ulaanbaatar is, look it up on a map. Study your geography a little bit more. Okay. So this is very unfamiliar land. I'm kind of new to this already. Oh, finally my shield did something. Finally. And what do you have to say, guy? Come here and buy some crap, will ya? I have lots of nice... I have lots with an apostrophe of nice items. Okay. Boomerang. Sure. Ba-ba-ba-ba! But do you need it? And apparently I cannot buy the key. Or can I buy the key? Let's just see. I can buy it for 25. That's actually pretty nifty. And I can actually buy the candle. You know, I can... Let me just do that right now, you know, just for shits and giggles, because I'm probably not going to be doing any more of this game after 5 more minutes are up. Okay, so, candle it is, then. It's a standard Zelda classic item. Yes, it is. Yes, it is indeed. Okay, so, with all that being said and done, let's actually head to the Orient. Let's head to Asia this time. I should probably forget saying Orient because it is offensive to some cultures, which I should probably... I'll try my very best to avoid, guys. I'm sorry for saying Orient. Because that's just kind of... It's kind of historic that way. I mean, it was historically used in the past, but in today's day and age, it's not exactly used anymore. So I'll just use East instead. Let's just head due East. After all, East is 4 letters and Orient is 6 letters. Hi, I come from the Occident, bearing gifts of frankincense and myrrh. Okay. Yeah, we 3 wise men, and apparently... Oh, wait. I wonder if I can burn this... Oh, okay. Let's select the candle here. That didn't work. Will this work? Nope. Will this work? Okay, well, will this work? No, it won't, so I guess I was always... Oh, here's a message. Why did you open this up screen? There is nothing in here. If you want to change your items, just use O and R, okay? Oh, I didn't know you could do that. Nevertheless, I wish you a Merry... Oh, thank you. And thank you for not capitalizing Merry Christmas. That's very, very vulgar of you. Okay, let's actually go back to the wand, because I think the wand is one of the best weapons in the game. I mean, just personally speaking. And, you know... I'm just gonna kill some more enemies, and I think we'll be done for right here. I think. Can kind of wrap things up a little bit. Okay, so let's actually... I'm guessing that was a mob. Actually, no, I could use 4 of these keys now to see if I can progress any further in that one cave. Which I'm seriously doubting I would just, you know, get through. Especially in this take. Is this it? No, you're the I wish I could just skip you. I really wish I could. At least your scroll speed is faster than in the original game. Because in the original game it's so slow. It is dangerous to go out alone. Take this sword. Buy something, will ya? It is a secret to everyone. Or actually more like, it is a secret to everyone. Okay. And here is this cave again, and bomb, bomb, ba, and babadi, badadoo. I guess we were halfway done, and unfortunately we can't make it to that one Christmas present, so alas, we can't make it. And alas, I must put an end to this special so soon, but it is, after all, over the 30-minute mark. So I'll just put this baby to bed here. So next time on... Next time on this year's holiday special of the Obnoxious Ubbo's repertoire. We are basically done with this game. I just wanted to have fun and see if I could just make it through this game without even getting damaged by Stalfos. It's like so very, very unwarrantedly, but unfortunately it couldn't be done. It couldn't be helped. So, yep, I guess this is the Christmas game that I was playing, and I give credit to the designer, even though a lot of grammatical mistakes, and you really should, you know, correct on those typos, because I know you can. But after all that being said and done, I wish you guys a Merry Christmas, a Happy Kwanzaa, and Happy Ramadan, and Happy Hanukkah, even though both Hanukkah and Ramadan are already done by this point.